This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command to this ummah, is to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to know them, their messenger. This glorious messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left behind us a sunnah to follow. In the beautiful hadith, the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-deenu naseehah." Deen is naseehah. And naseehah is a word in the Arabic language that has different meanings. One of the meanings is to be pure. So we get from it a derived meaning, ikhlas. That deen is sincerity. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They were only commanded to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ الدِّينَ. And ibadah is ma'rifah. In the Qur'an, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I only created the jinn and the humans to worship, to do ibadah. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, لِيَعْرِفُونَ. To know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you cannot worship that which you are ignorant of. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدِّينُ نَصِيحَ. And nasaha also means to sew a patch onto, to fix a torn garment. And this is nasiha. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَدَأُ الْإِسْلَامُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيْعُودُ كَمَا بَدَأَ غَرِيبًا فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. The deen of Islam began a strange and alien thing in Mecca. And it will return a strange and alien thing. فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. And they said, who are the strangers, Ya Rasulullah? And he said, الَّذِينَ يُصْلِحُونَ شَرِيعَتِي بَعْدَمَا أَفْسَدَهَا النَّاسِ. Those are the ones that rectify my sharia. And that is nasiha, because nasiha means to rectify. Those who rectify my sharia, my way, my path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after the people have ruined it, have corrupted it, have changed it, they rectify it. وَإِنَّمَا يَحْمِرُ هَذَا الدِّينَ فِي كُلِّ قَرْنٍ عُدُولُهُ. The Prophet ﷺ said, they will carry this deen in every generation, those righteous and upright and just people. And they will always be, لَا تَزَارُ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْ أُمَّتِي ظَاهِرِينَ عَلَى الْحَقِّ لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ مَنْ خَالَفُهُمْ وَمَنْ خَذَلَهُمْ. The Prophet ﷺ said, there will always be a group from my ummah, a ta'ifa that's on the truth. And ظاهرينَ, they will be manifest on the truth. No one can harm them who goes against them or who forsakes them and turns and leaves them. حَتَّى تَقُومَ السَّعَ وَهُمْ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. And the hour will come and they're like that. And so the Prophet ﷺ said that nasiha is first to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I don't want to look into that, but that's a deep statement. I want to look at the next one. And then he said, النَّصِيحَةُ لِرَسُولِهِ. And then they said, فَمَنْ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. And then after that, to who? And he said, to his messenger. And then they asked him. And then the Prophet ﷺ said, to his book, and then to the general Muslims, and then to their elect in one riwayah, and in another one to the imams of the Muslims, and then to the general Muslims. And in this hadith, when he said, الدِّينُ نَصِيحَةً, and he said to the messenger, Ahmed Zarruq radiallahu anhu, the great scholar from North Africa, said that this has three elements. The first one is, فِاتِّبَاعِ سُنَّتِهِ, in following his sunnah. That is nasiha to the messenger of Allah. And this is an integral part of our deen, is following the sunnah of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his sunnah has characteristics. There is an outward sunnah, and then there is an inward sunnah. And they are, we cannot relinquish the importance of the outward by emphasizing the inward. Nor can we emphasize the outward while forgetting the inward. One of the ulama of al-Maghrib, when somebody was complaining, because Moroccan ulama are, I don't want to say notorious, but they're well known for shaving their beard except for a little growth. They just leave a little, according to some Maliki fuqaha who gave them ijazah to do that. So they leave just a little bit, and in the lihya, in the Arabic language, liha is from the lihya, which is the jawbone. And so the Maliki fuqaha said that the lihya is actually just on the jawbone. And so they can shave from the two sides and leave just on. So that you find ulama in Morocco, they just have along the jawbone, the bare minimum. So one of the younger men, because young people tend to get very passionate about certain things. He said, "Ya Shaykh, why don't you let your beard grow long?" And the Shaykh said, "I wish the people of this age," and he's talking about a certain group of people, he said, "I wish the people of this age would lengthen their robes," because some people like to wear a short robe, would lengthen their robe, shorten their beards, but shorten their talk and lengthen their prayer. In other words, and I'm not saying that that's what they should do, lengthen their robe or shorten their beard. But he was emphasizing a point. If you only emphasize the outward of the sunnah and you forget the inward of the sunnah, then what do you have? That's called nifaq. When your outward manifests something and your inward hides another thing which is different. Now the Prophet ﷺ, his dress is part of his sunnah. But if you look at the Prophet ﷺ's dress, it was unique amongst the Arabs in that he had a robe from the Romans, from the Europeans. And this is in the Sahih, in Shama'il al-Tirmidhi, that he had a qamis romani, he had a Yemeni burda, he had a Habashi shirt. He wore things from different places, but they had certain characteristics. The one is modesty. They were modest clothes. And you look at all the Muslim ummah, all of the clothes of the indigenous cultures are modest in nature, even if they don't appear the same outwardly. And we're not saying everybody should look the same. Like a garden that has many different types of flowers and has many different types of fruits. The Quran says we give them from one water with fruits of varying colors and tastes. So the water of the sunnah is one, but what the fruit of it looks different and tastes different, but it's all pleasant. Those of this age reek of atheism. They reek of atheism. And this means the men and the women, not simply the men, wearing these tight jeans. And jeans level human beings, make them all look like slaves. You wear the clothes of a factory worker.